Hey friends, I'm Tasia, and welcome to your Google Drive 2020 tutorial, where I'll show you how to use Google Drive and highlight some of the best Google Drive features. So about a year ago, I did a video on the best Google Drive features, and I'll be sure to leave a link to that below and again at the end of this video. But for this video, I really wanted to do an in-depth tutorial on how to use Google Drive. And since we're about 6 months into 2020, I know, I can't believe where the time went either, I figured now's a good time to highlight some of the aesthetic and functionality updates that have happened this last year in Google Drive. So without further ado, let's dive in to Drive. If you're new to Google Drive, let's start with what is Google Drive? Google Drive is a free cloud storage solution. It features file storage, file sharing, and file syncing across your devices. So if you've ever used or read a Google Doc, for example, that's all part of the Google Drive ecosystem. So let's dive in here and find out the multiple ways you can access Google Drive. Now, for me, I always access my Drive from my Gmail or my GCal, but you can even access it from your YouTube account, and it looks the same from either spot. So here we are in my GCal, and if you click on the Google Apps in the top right, it's this square made of dots, all your Google Apps will pop up here. And you can click on Google Drive right from here. Now, if you're super new to the Google ecosystem or you haven't even set up Drive yet, you can also head to drive.google.com. And here, Google has provided a great overview for you on the benefits of Google Drive, and you can access Drive directly from here as well. They have Drive for teams or individuals, so this is what we're going to be focusing on for your personal Google account. So you can click Go to Drive, or you can download Drive if you prefer that option. Now, once you click Go to Drive, you'll either be brought directly to your Drive if you've already signed into your Google account, or you'll see a page like this asking you to sign into your Google account. And by the way, you can also create an account here right from this page too. So if you don't have a Google account yet, you can do so right here. Once you've signed into your Google account and you've opened Drive, your Drive may look a little bit different in this main section here, depending on whether or not you've created any files. But the basic layout with these options on the left are gonna look the same regardless. Now, if your Drive layout in this main area still looks different than what I'm showing you, you can adjust your layout using the option in the top right here to switch to the list view or grid view. It's really just a personal preference. Now, something I want to point out right away. You might notice my Drive shows 17 gigabytes of storage. Yours might show 15 gigabytes of storage. Now, I've gone over before in another video why I have 17 gigs as opposed to 15 gigs for free, so I'm not going to repeat that here. But if you guys are interested in learning all about Google storage options and what's free and what's paid, I'll link to my other video below and again at the end of this video that's going to tell you all about the storage options. So let's begin with how to create a new file in Google Drive. As you might be able to guess, you would click on New in the top left. Here, you have the option to create a new folder, upload a file or folder. You can create a Google Doc, a sheet, or a slide, and then you'll have more options underneath that where you can create fillable forms and other things like that. So if you don't have anything in your Drive yet, a good place to start would be to create a new folder. Now think of how you want to organize all of your files here. So for example, I have a YouTube video folder. Now this folder holds all of my YouTube scripts and some other notes regarding my YouTube channel. So go ahead and create your folder. And for now I'll create a client outreach folder and I'll hit create. And bam, right here under folders, you have your new folder. Now, if you're in list view, and I'll toggle back to that to show you here, you'll be able to get a quick snapshot of the owner of the file, when it was last modified and by who, as well as the file's size. So now I'm just gonna toggle back to my grid view. So if you wanna upload a file that already exists on your computer, head back to new and select file upload. Then just select the file you want to upload and it'll be added to your drive. Essentially, any type of file can be uploaded here. A video file, PDF file, image file, Photoshop file, on and on. Plus, you can upload multiple files at once by hitting Control Select or Command Select on a Mac. Just like you can upload a file, you can upload an entire folder as well. So now let's talk about how to create a file from scratch. Let's use creating a Google Doc as an example. Now, you can click on the Google Docs option here, or you can hover over the arrow to the right, and you'll have the option to create a blank document or create a doc from a template. So, time out. Let's take a moment to talk about the awesome feature that is templates in Google Drive. I think this is one of the best features, hands down. So let's check it out. Let's click on this template option. A new tab opens and you can scroll through a boatload of doc templates like resumes and letters, different types of project proposals, sales templates, legal templates, contractor templates, and more. So if you're working on a lesson plan, for example, just click that template and voila, the template is automatically opened for you to edit. And you can edit anything and everything from the title to the text to the colors and the layout and more. And by the way, templates are available for Google Sheets, Google Slides, and more. So get in there, dig around, and use these templates to your advantage. Okay, time in, back to creating a file. We're using a doc as an example, so let's create a new doc. Again, you'll notice a new tab is automatically opened here. Click the title of the doc to rename it. Any changes you make on a file in Drive will be auto-saved for you. So once you've created a file, you'll want to keep everything organized in Drive. So at the top, near your title that you've just changed, click the little folder icon and select the folder you want to move it to. So we'll select the test folder that I created earlier and then click Move. Now, back in my Drive tab, I can open my folder and voila, the doc that I've created is right here. Now, another feature that allows for easy file retrieval is the ability to star a file. That's right at the top near your file name as well. And once you've starred something, it'll be found in the starred section of your Google Drive on that left-hand panel. Now, you don't always have to open the file in order to move or favorite it. So from this main Drive page, you can right-click on a file and look at all these options you have. You can share it or make a shareable link, which I'll go over in more detail in a little bit, show a file location, move or favorite it, rename the file, copy the file, download it to your computer, delete it, and more. There are so many features available with just a right click. Now, something else you might notice is the different icons for different files. And that's a quick visual cue that Google's showing you without you having to open the file. So whether it's a doc or a spreadsheet or a PDF or whatever it may be, the little icon will be different. So I've gone over sharing settings in my other Google Drive video, but let's go over them in more detail and also how to set your sharing permissions. Now, remember how Google provides you with a visual cue as to what you're looking at? Well, if you have a little icon with a person in it, that means it's shared. Now, there's multiple ways you can share a file. You can do it from the file itself when you're creating it, or you can do it from your main Google Drive page. So like I showed you before, you can right-click on any file in order to share it, or if you click to select a file, on the top right of Drive, you'll have a few options. If you click the person icon with a plus symbol, a sharing pop-up appears where you can add the email addresses of those you want to share it with. You can add multiple people if you want, and to the right of the person you're adding, you can set the sharing permissions here. You can allow them viewing access only, the ability to comment, or the ability to edit the document just as you can. And you can even write a little message here for your collaborators too. And when you're ready to share, just click send. If you don't want to add people directly, you can also create a shareable link. So only people with the link will be able to view that file. So back in your Drive with the file selected, just click the link icon in the top right. And in this pop-up, you can copy the link as well as adjust the link sharing permissions here too. So if you're new to sharing and collaborating, you'll definitely want to check out the other video I did where I cover some of the awesome Google Drive features of collaboration, like viewing and tending to comments and being able to see a complete revision history of your file. But right now for this video, I want to focus on another feature, and that's your search feature. Once you have a lot of files in your Drive, you're going to want to easily pull them all up. So at the top of your Drive, you have a search bar. Type in whatever it is you're looking for, and voila, it'll appear. I use this all the time since I have so many YouTube scripts. Sometimes I need to pull up an old one really quickly, and this is my go-to feature for doing that. Well, that's my Google Drive 2020 tutorial for you. Now I want to hear from you. What do you love about Google Drive? And what are some of your favorite Google Drive features? Let everybody know in the comments below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, I want to know, so give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and somewhere up here for that other Google Drive video. Do it! Click it anytime now. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you next time.